on monumental landscape. I don't have a Black History, nothing to say about it, but I just want to remind you all, please come out every fourth Saturday, downstairs or across the street, whichever is available, at 10:30 a.m. to our Black History class. We not only teach Black History, we talk about the present and future things that's going on in our world. So just come and support us, and you'll learn something and enjoy yourself. Thank you. This Friday at 7 o'clock will be a rehearsal for the combined choirs. And so we all know that this is Advent season, and we opened the first Sunday talking about Advent. And so today we're going to wrap it up with love. And the Bible tells us a lot about love. The Bible tells us to love thy neighbor, love them that hate the Lord. We are encouraged to love the Lord. We know that the Lord persevereth them that love him, and we ought to love the Lord our God. How many of you know that Jesus is love?
Oh, yeah.
The sacrifice that he did is the utmost, greatest example of love. Giving his life for us, yes. Sinners, when he knew no sin was love. Withstanding the beatings that he took at Calvary, hanging on that cross for us was love. All for us, Jesus is the resemblance of love. And so as we go throughout this season, it is not about the money that you can spend. It is not about the presents that you can receive. It is not about anything other than Jesus and love. And so I encourage you on this morning, in your walk with love. Take long strides with love. In your talk, show compassion, show love, show empathy, sympathy to the people that you come into contact with. In your thoughts, before you think anything that's other than Jesus, I want you to think about love, loving your neighbor, loving your enemy, doing what's right, thinking about what would Jesus do in this situation. And everything that you do, especially in this season, show love. There are so many people who are without loved ones. There are so many people who are lonely during this time, who are hungry, who are homeless during this time. There are so many needs. And if we could just show love, we'll make this world a little brighter.
Amen.
Love on this morning.
Amen.
And so now we'll have a selection by our choir.
Thank you.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee. Genesis 28:22. It's important to give, as I say. It takes care of the church. Need I say more? With that being said, please let the ushers come forth and collect the first fruits of the Lord.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
real quick. We need a couple of cards that we received. One was a thank you card. Thank you for the love and prayers from Deaconess Freeman. And also we received a card on behalf of Rosalind Waters Maxwell. She wanted to give us a thank you as well for our generosity for the Church Mothers.
Amen.
All right, church, it's time for the word.
Amen.
How many of you need a word to just carry on? You know, all that singing and all that other stuff is really good, but sometimes we need that word.
Amen.
You know, we need that word to just accompany it, you know, just to have that joy to go throughout this week. And so on this morning, there's been a slight change, not due to anyone's fault, but we still have a familiar face in the pulpit. We have a familiar minister that we have heard over the years to come forward and bless us with the word. She's a mother of two, and she is no stranger to Monumental. Minister Suzette Nesbitt will be ordained in the by the choir. I want you guys to get your minds ready, get your Bibles ready, and hear the word coming from God's child. Amen?
Amen.